Hello guys, so welcome to your YouTube channel that is Sai Engineers, which is helping you in your MHCET preparation and in the future will be helping you in your engineering studies also. This is Sushant and we would like to welcome you to our third video for our random questions. We'll be taking up yet another set of questions which will be from different topics. Before we get going, I would like to remind you to please like, share and comment in the comment section about the new format of video which we are doing. So let's get going on the first question. So let's get going for the first question. The first question is telling us that they have given a tan of something plus tan of some other thing is equal to something of this. Now if you just observe, we have the same angles which are present inside the tan. It is just differing by a minus and a plus sign. So this is basically a formula for a tan of pi by 4 plus theta plus tan of pi by 4 minus theta. So what you can do is you can just take this thing as some theta and then solve for it. So considering this as my theta, I can write it as tan of pi by 4 plus theta plus tan of pi by 4 minus theta. We can apply the formula for tan of a plus b. So that's going to be, for this case it's my pi by 4 which is a, so I can write it as a 1 plus tan theta divided by 1 minus tan theta. On this side it's going to be a 1 minus tan theta upon 1 plus tan theta. So if you solve this, if you just cross multiply, it's going to be 1 plus tan theta the whole square plus 1 minus tan theta the whole square divided by, it's going to be a plus b, a minus b, so that's going to be 1 minus tan square. So now this is your a plus b the whole square plus a minus b the whole square. So you should able to recollect that's going to be twice of a square plus b square. So that's going to be a square which is 1 plus b square which is going to be tan square theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta. So now what you are having is a 1 plus tan square theta, which you can write it as sec square theta. So that's going to be 2 sec square theta divided by 1 minus tan square theta. Now you can just convert this sec and your tan in your beloved sine and cos. So you'll be getting it as a 2 upon cos square divided by 1. So this is going to be sine upon cos. So that's going to be LCM over here. So that's a cos square theta minus sine square theta divided by cos square theta. But there's a cos square division in the numerator also that gets cancelled out. So this is a formula for your cos 2 theta. So now you know that your theta is nothing but this particular thing. So let us just substitute that in that. So you'll be getting a 2 divided by cos of 2 into your theta is 1 by 2 cos inverse a by b. So the 2 gets cancelled. This is a cos of cos inverse which basically nullifies each other. So you'll be getting a 2 by a by b. So that's a 2b by a. So if you just check out in the option, it's going to be your option B. Let us consider the second question which is given to us, that is a tan x upon tan 2x plus tan 2x upon tan x plus 2 equals 0. So what you can do is, let us just simplify this. Let us take this part as m. So this will be nothing but 1 by m. So this thing is equal to plus 2 equals 0. So what you can do is you can solve this. So m square plus 2m plus 1 equals 0. So that is a formula for m plus 1 the whole square equals 0. So you will be getting as m is equal to minus 1. So basically what you are getting it as, a tan x upon tan 2x is minus 1. Now your tan x will remain on this side will be equal to tan 2x, that is minus of tan 2x. Your tan 2x is nothing but the formula for 2 tan x upon 1 minus tan square x. So your tan x gets cancelled on both sides. So you're having 1 minus tan square x equals to minus 1. So your minus tan square x equals minus 3. So your tan x is nothing but plus minus root 3. So you'll be getting this as tan x equals plus minus tan of pi by 3. Now your plus minus can go inside. So you'll be having a tan x equals tan of plus minus pi by 3. So this is your form, that is your tan x equals tan alpha form. For that, which is a general equation, which is given by the formula, which is n pi plus minus alpha. So that's going to be your option B. So let us go for the next question. They have given that area of triangle is given as this thing. Then I have to find my tan A. So what you can do is you can consider this equation, that is area of triangle, which is given to me as A square. So let us expand that thing. So that's going to be a minus of B square minus 2BC plus C square. So if I open the bracket, it's going to be A square minus B square minus will be becoming plus 2BC minus C square. So if I just combine your B square, C square and A square, you will be getting it as 2BC minus bracket, it will be B square minus C square, B square plus C square minus A square. So your B square plus C square minus A square, you can use your cos formula over there. So that's going to be a 2BC minus, this is going to be a 2BC cos A. So you can take your 2BC constant, you will be having a 1 minus cos A on this side. So this 1 minus cos A can be written as a 2 sine square A by 2. So what you will be getting it as a 4BC sine square A by 2. So now I know that my area of triangle is also given by the formula, that is half of BC sine A. So using this formula, what I can do is my BC gets cancelled. So my sine A, I can write it as a 2 sine A by 2 cos A by 2. So my one of the sine gets cancelled. So what you will be having a cos on that side, that will give you a tan A by 2. My tan A by 2 will be giving me the value of 1 by 4. So now you have to find the value of tan A. Now my tan A using my half angle formula can be written as a 2 tan A by 2 upon 1 minus tan square A by 2. So substituting the value, you will be getting it as 2 into 1 by 4 divided by 1 minus 1 by 16. So if you solve that value, it's going to be 8 by 15 as the answer. So that will be your answer. The next one, we have number of values of x in the interval 0 to 3 pi satisfying the equation which is given by this. So now we have to basically solve this quadratic equation in my sine. So let us solve the quadratic equation in this. So you'll be getting it as a 2 sine square x plus 5 sine x minus 3 equals 0. You require the product as minus 6, that is minus 3 into 2, and you require the addition as plus 5. So for that to happen, we can take it as a minus 1 and plus 6. So the values are sine x will be equal to half, or sine x equals minus 3. But this thing cannot be possible because my sine cannot be more than 1 or minus 1. So my sine x can be having the value half. Now wherever the value of sine x is having half, you have to understand that it is from 0 to 3 pi. From 0 to 3 pi, we know that the sine will be completing 1.5 cycle. So you will be having this as pi, this as 2 pi, and this will be your 3 pi. So your sine is completing 1.5 cycle, and in that you will be getting your values of half over here. So you will be having a 2 value over here and 2 values over here. So you will be getting the answer as A for this. Moving to the next one, we have values of x at which the first derivative of the function is with respect to x is going to be 3/4. So we have to find derivative of this function and we have to find the value of x so that this derivative is going to get me the value 3/4. So let us first consider that equation. So considering the equation, we'll be getting it as root x plus 1/√x the whole square. So squaring, opening the bracket, I'll be getting it as x plus root 2 root x into 1/√x, so that's going to be 2 plus 1/x. So I have to take derivative of this. So this is my f of x, I have to take derivative. So f dash of x is going to be 1 for x, 0 for 2, and it's going to be minus 1/x² for 1/x. So now what I need is that the derivative, that is the first derivative, is given as 3/4. So this value is to be 3/4. Now I have to find the value of x. So I'll be getting it as 1/x² is equal to 1/4. So basically my x should be having the value of plus and minus 2. So you can just check your option A. Moving to the next one, we have a y equals root of 1 plus tan x upon 1 minus tan x, and you have to find the derivative of this. Now it's now this particular equation is quite complicated, so we need to simplify this equation. So what we can do is your y will be equal to this thing will be root of 1 minus tan 1. So it's root of 1 plus tan x upon 1 minus tan x. So this particular formula is nothing but formula for root of tan of π/4 plus x. So now you have to find derivative of root of tan π/4 plus x. So if you find the derivative, the first derivative, that is going to be root derivative, that is 1 upon 2 root tan of π/4 plus x into derivative of tan, which is going to be sec square, that is π/4 plus x. Now you're getting this particular derivative, that is the first derivative, as this particular thing. You have sec square π/4 plus x in all the three options except the last one, which is none of the above, and you don't have this particular term in your any of the option. If you take your option D, that is none of the above, then actually you're wrong, because you need to again write this thing in the substituted form, which is that this particular form, because you had written your 1 plus tan x upon 1 minus tan x as tan π/4 plus x. So you need to write that thing. So it will be 1/2 root of, it's 1 upon that, so it's going to be the inverted form of it. So it's 1 minus tan x upon 1 plus tan x into sec square π/4 plus x. Moving to the integral ones, we have e raised to x 2 plus sine 2x upon 1 plus cos 2x dx. We need to find derivative integration of this. So whenever you have e raised to x, you have to always remember to apply your f of x plus f dash of x form. So what you require, you need to find your f of x and you need your derivative also in that particular term. So now let us try to simplify this. So what you can do is you can just simplify this using, let us concentrate on this bracket, that is my 2 plus sine 2x. So I can write it as 2 plus sine 2x, I can write it as 2 sine x cos x. So if I take the 2 common, so I'll be getting it as 1 plus sine x cos x divided by, I am having a 1 plus cos 2x. Now my 1 plus cos 2x, I can write it as a 2 cos square x. So my 2 gets cancelled out and I'll be getting, So now what I can do is I can split it up. So I'm having 1 upon cos square. So that's going to be a sec square x plus. If I do sin x upon cos x, the cos x gets cancelled. So I'm having a tan x. So now you have to decide on what should be the function and what its derivative is going to be. So obviously my function should be tan, because tan's derivative is going to be sec square x. So now solution for this particular integral, you have to remember it's going to be e raised to x f of x. So in this case, since your function was this f of x and its derivative was this, so your answer should be e raised to x into tan x. So that option should be your C option. Moving to the last question for the day. So it's is integration of sine of root x dx. Now for this particular question, people have a tendency to write it as a cos of root x and such things, but that is quite wrong, because your sine will be cos only when you have a linear term which is present inside the sine. Otherwise, there is the formula which is present in the table is not applicable. So that is why you have to convert this particular into a simplified format. So basically what you have to do is you have to go for substitution method. So now you have a root x which is a complicated term. My suggestion is whenever there is a complicated term present, that is mostly the substitution to be done. Now if I substitute my root x as t, now I have to bring my dx also in terms of dt, and I have to get rid of all the x terms in this particular equation. So I have to manipulate accordingly. So if I take derivative of this, so I will be getting it as 1 upon 2 root x, which is equal to dt. Now in this equation, I can see that there is no 1 upon root x. So there is no 1 upon root x which is present. So what you can do is you can write this root x as t, and then this will turn out to be dx is equal to 2t dt. So now every term which is present in the integral has been changed to the substituted term. So then only you should understand that your substitution is done in the right way. So what you are doing is, now my sine of root x will be written as sine t, your dx will be written as 2t dt. So now you have a t sin t dt. So basically now this is my UV rule. So as I had discussed how to solve the UV rule, you have to take the derivative term on the left hand side of the column and the integration term on the right hand side of the column. You have to take continuous derivative of the derivative. So it's going to be 1 and 0. You have to stop at 0, and you have to take integration of sine. So that's going to be a minus cos t. Integration of cos t, it's going to be minus sin t. So now then you have to draw these arrows with a plus and minus. So your answer is going to be minus t cos t, minus of minus going to be plus sin t. But you don't require your t, so you have to resubstitute the value. So you'll be getting it as minus root x cos root x plus sin root x. One more thing we have forgotten about the 2. So the 2 is going to be outside. So if you look out for this particular option, it's going to be in your option D. So thank you guys. Please do share, like and subscribe to our channel. And please do comment. If you are new to the channel, I would like to remind you that we have also video lectures on each individual topics, which are there in the playlist for your MHCET, which you can get from the channel. Your comments and your suggestions will be quite helpful for us to make such videos in the future. And also, please, I would like to remind you that after your MHCET, we also have video lectures for your engineering subjects, which is going to be in your first and second year of engineering. So signing off, this is Sushan. So keep learning, keep watching, and happy learning. Bye.